Of the Breton harbor of Brest, largest anchorage in Europe and most important U-boat base in France, near the close of the 28-day siege ending 20th September. On 11th September, Battery C, 243rd Field Artillery Battalion, brings forward an 8-inch gun to fire point blank at the massive wall surrounding the fortress where Nazi paratroop General Hermann Bernhard Rahmke is offering bitter resistance. September with Major General Troy H. Middleton and Major General Albert C. Wedemeyer. Following General Eisenhower's order that bombing and shelling of the besieged city be continued until capitulation, P-47s of the 9th Air Force dive bomb Nazi installations and remnants of an estimated original garrison of 20,000. The Germans resisted fanatically. General Rahmke had told them, "Every soldier marching against us is one less threat against the homeland." By the Nazis supplemented damage to railroad yards and docks from American air and land bombardment. American infantrymen take up positions in a captured strong point overlooking the waterfront. An element of the 705th Tank Destroyer Battalion goes into action. Snipers had held up progress through this street before arrival of the armored vehicle. Equipped with Bangalore torpedoes, a demolition squad of A Company, 23rd Regiment, 2nd Division, sets out to reduce German pillboxes still blocking a general entry into the city on 11th September. Nazis demolish docks and submarine pens as the siege nears its end.